To the naked eye, the ocean looks like a vast expanse of water, boundless in its reach and soul-stirring in its mystery. The ocean is actually divided into zones and areas, sort of like how we've divvied up land into countries, states, and so forth. For starters, every coastal and island nation has an exclusive economic zone, or EEZ, that area of sea and seabed that extends outward from a country's shoreline, up to 200 nautical miles offshore. Each country has exclusive rights within its EEZ to exploit, conserve, and manage the natural resources there, including marine life, minerals, gas, and oil beneath the sea floor, and wind and hydrologic energy. Some countries subdivide their EEZs into areas with special restrictions. For example, a zone where only smaller boats are allowed to fish, or a marine reserve that's closed to any activity that might disturb the plants or animals living there. The area of ocean outside of all exclusive economic zones is called the high seas, often referred to as the commons, because technically, the high seas are a resource to be shared, managed, and governed by everyone in the world. There's no zoning commission for the high seas, and no signs to tell marine creatures that they've crossed that border. There isn't even a TSA security checkpoint. The United Nations does have a treaty called the Law of the Sea, which sets some rules on what people can do out here. But it's all very loosely governed. The high seas account for about two-thirds of the world's ocean, or about 98 million square miles, which means each of us can claim, let's see, 7 billion into 98 million, carry the two, convert the square miles. A nice little parcel of water in our real estate portfolio,